Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install latest version of Flutter on the Windows operating system. So to install Flutter, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and to type over here Flutter download. Hit enter. So that will show you this www.flutter.dev. So just simply go to their official site and it's going to redirect to the official site of flutter.dev. So just simply click on get started. So this link I'm going to provide right in your channel description. Here we are going to download it for Windows. So I'm going to select Windows and we are going to download it on our desktop. So we're just simply going to click on desktop and that's going to show you this page. Here you need to scroll down and you will get it is available for Flutter in Visual Studio Code or standalone. So I'm going to switch to the standalone download and install, and I'm just going to click on this Flutter Windows link. That's going to immediately start downloading our Flutter. So let's cancel it as I have already downloaded Flutter. And when you scroll down over here, you are going to see a warning message over here. So all it is telling is not to put Flutter in such a folder which has a special characters or spaces. So that is basically it should not be having any space. For example, if you see this program space files, so we don't want to put Flutter in those kind of places. All right, and also we should not be putting Flutter in such a folder where it requires elevated privileges. So basically it is telling not to put on this type of folders. So what we are going to do, everything I'm going to show you on this video itself. All right, so just continue watching this video. So let's go to your download directory, and here is our Flutter, and our file size is 1 gigabyte. So you need to take care of that once when you download Flutter. So after downloading Flutter, just right click and click on extract all. So let's extract our Flutter right over here. You can see it is rightly started extracting. So let's wait for a couple of minutes. And here is our Flutter rightly extracted, and these are all files and folders you can see. So let's close this. So here is our extracted folders. If you go inside, you will get a Flutter folder over here. So that is what we need to cut it. And we need to go to a C drive, and just we are going to simply paste it over here. We are not going to paste in any other folder. We are going to just simply going to paste on our C drive, right on our C drive. Just go inside and you will get a bin folder over here. So just simply go inside that bin folder, and you need to just select this and you need to copy this C Flutter slash bin folder path. Now go to search and type environ. So that will show you this editor system environment variables. Open that and click on environment variables. So that will open this environment variable window. Here you need to click on path and you need to click on edit, and you need to click on new and right click and paste that Flutter slash bin folder path over here. Now click on OK, then again OK, and then again OK. And now if you close all these folders and our browser as well, and just simply go to search and type cmd to open your command prompt. And here if you just simply type flutter space dash dash version and just simply hit enter, you are going to see this type of prompt. So if you are getting this type of prompt, then all that basically mean is your Flutter is rightly installed on your system. In some cases, before showing this type of prompt, it might also download some dependencies. For example, in one of my desktop it shows that. That's totally fine, just wait for a few more seconds to download all of dependencies, and then you are going to get this type of prompt. So if you are getting this type of prompt, then your Flutter is rightly installed. So in this way you can easily install latest version of Flutter on your Windows operating system. Do follow our other videos on our channel, that includes your Python project playlist. I am sure if you are following these videos, then you are going to love it. And entire source code and everything you are going to get on our GitHub account and our official site. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.